Hi, welcome to the HomeKit Show. This week, we're going to talk about Philips Hue and all the new products they've announced, along with Yale's new Smart Lock and Cabinet Lock. Hi, welcome back. My name's John, and this channel is dedicated to everything HomeKit, news, reviews, and tutorials. So if you are into HomeKit and you want to find out more, so don't forget to subscribe to the channel and also hit the bell button to be notified when new HomeKit videos come out. Also check out our social channels on Facebook, Instagram and Twitter at Follow HomeKit, and also check out our website, homekitauthority.com, for more HomeKit news, reviews and tutorials. So first up is Philips Hue. This week they invited us to a press event to talk about some of their new product. The first up is Philips Hue Play Gradient Light Strip. Now this is similar to the existing LED light strip, however, it's got a multicolor capability. So this is really aimed to be used with the Sync Box to enhance your movie theater experience in your living room. Basically what it does, it works with Sync Box, it then changes the colors based on what's happening on the screen. It creates a fully immersive surround lighting experience with the ability to produce almost unlimited number of colors at the same time. This is specifically designed for TVs, which can easily be mounted and is available in three sizes. This means it cannot be cut like the existing light strip. So it comes in a 55 inch, 65 and 75 inch to fit most TVs that are available in people's homes. Now, a lot of people are already saying on Twitter and various other social platforms, this is an expensive product. And it is, it starts $199, goes all the way up to $230. And for a light strip, if you're gonna use it only for a light strip, it is an expensive product. But if you are a movie geek and you're into your home theater, this type of product is not that expensive. Particularly if you've already bought the Sync Box and you've already got other Play products in your home, then adding this into your home movie theater experience, I don't think is a hard sell. And I think if you look at it from that point of view, then I think you truly appreciate what this product will do. Obviously, no one's had chance to actually use one of these and whether any good, but given Philips Hue's previous experience with designing great product, then I think it's gonna work really well. Now, until such time I do get one in to test, then I'm not gonna be able to give you a firm opinion. But in terms of the price, for the 55 inch, it comes in at $199 or 179 euros. For the 65 inch, it's €199 or $219. And for the 75 inch, it's €229 or $239. They will be available from the 6th of October in North America, Europe, and Australia and New Zealand. Now you can pre-order today from the Philips Hue website, and you can find out more about them and also the Hue Sync Box that it specifically is designed to work with. Now the other products that Philips Hue have announced is the Philips Hue Iris. Now they're saying they put a new spin on an already existing device that offers richer colors, lower than ever dimming, and a significant increase in brightness when used as a white light. It also comes in various new colors, which are the limited edition versions, which are copper, rose, silver, and gold, as well as the existing colors that are already available today. The Iris works with HomeKit when connected to the Philips Hue Bridge, and it's gonna be available from the 6th of October across Europe, US, and Canada, starting at €99 or $99. And for the limited edition version colors, it's gonna start at €119. Next up is additions to the vintage filament range. They will come in a large globe size and a large Edison size. Now these have been in popular demand and a lot of other brands are starting to launch these, and it's great to see these come in bigger sizes. I was only in IKEA the other week and I saw a large globe version of a dumb bulb, and I thought that'd be great if available in a smart bulb. And now Philips Hue are launching it. Now it's obviously only gonna be a matter of time before other brands follow, but these are gonna be available from the 29th of September. They're gonna be available across Europe, starting at $39.95 for the large globe and $34.95 for the large Edison. Of course, they will work with HomeKit when you pair them with the U-Bridge, and you'll be able to use them the exact same way as you do with other used products. Now, next up is some products from Yale, the Yale Linus Smart Lock and the Yale Cabinet Smart Lock. Now, first up, I want to talk about is the Yale Linus. Now, this was announced back at CES 2020. This week, Yale has confirmed via a virtual press event that the Yale Linus Smart Lock will be available from October, priced at €249. The Yale Linus comes in matte black and silver and is made from metal. The lock is designed to fit onto your existing Euro lock cylinder, so it leaves your lock intact. So from the outside, there's no change and the door can still be operated in the traditional way with your regular key. The lock is powered by 4 AA batteries, and Yale told me that they could last up to 6 months with typical usage. I can imagine this typical usage is opening and closing the door on a daily basis. Yale claims that Linus is quick to install and can install without the need of professional insulation. However, you do need a compatible lock cylinder to fit the Linus to your door. But if you don't, Yale does sell an adjustable cylinder. Now, connectivity is provided by Bluetooth, and you can unlock it with your smartphone, provided it's in range, and send virtual keys to other people. These keys can be permanent or temporary, making it useful if you have guests. For added peace of mind, your Yale app and your account is protected by 2FA. Plus, if you lose your phone, you can disable your virtual keys. The lock also comes with an auto unlock feature, which you can automatically unlock your door when you leave. Then when you return home and walk up to your door, the auto unlock will then unlock it and allows you easy access. There's also an optional wireless pin pad that you can buy, letting people unlock the door via a code, which will be particularly useful for an Airbnb property. The Yale app also can keep a record of who has come home in your home, so this will be particularly useful if you have guests that arrived or you have children arrived home. Then you can then check the activity feed to see when they've arrived home. As I've already mentioned, it works via Bluetooth, so if you're not at home, you will need the Yale Connect Wi-Fi bridge to work it remotely. So you'll need this all connected up so you can use the remote lock-in and unlocking from the Yale app, and also allowing people in when you're not at home. However, there is some great news. The Yale Linus works with Apple HomeKit without an additional hub, which is really great news that you can use this with HomeKit directly without having an additional hub. Now, if you do want to use this remotely, you still need a HomeKit hub within your home, like with any other accessory, which means that if you are going to be using it with exclusively with HomeKit, you've got a HomeKit hub already, then you don't need to buy the Yale Connect Wi-Fi bridge to use it remotely, and you can still unlock it via the Ohm app or lock, or do any of the features that are available within HomeKit. As I've already mentioned, it works with Euro style cylinder locks, but it also works with multi-point locks, which is found on UPC or composite doors, which this type of lock is the one that you lift the handle before you lock it to engage all the different struts into the doors. Now, it's really important to point out that the auto lock feature does not work with multi-point locks. This is because you have to lift the handle in order to engage the lock. However, the auto unlock feature does work. Now, I did ask them a number of questions, and I have got a follow-up next week to discuss how the app works and how some of the other functionality, and I will be updating the article which I've put on the website. Now, the Linus will go on sale in early October for €249. Do want the Wi-Fi Connect bridge, that's $79.99, and the keypad is an additional $69.99. They also kindly sent me over some footage of it working with a multi-point lock and also working with the HomeKit.
Hi John, off to your great question. We just so happen to have a multi-point lock door in the office, so I thought I'd do a little bit of a demo to you to show that it does work with multi-point lock. So, to open it, just like a normal lock, tap the button, that's it, it's unlocking. And then to lock it, all you need to do, as you said, lift the handle, and then it will just work in the exact same way. So, hey Siri, lock the front door. And that's
it. Room door is locked.
All locked.
Next up is the Yale Smart Cabinet Lock. Now, this is the world's first HomeKit cabinet lock that is due to be released by the end of the year. The cabinet lock can be mounted on existing cabinet doors and drawers with single or double doors. Control is via the Yale app and works with HomeKit without the need for additional hub. Now, the cabinet lock comes in two parts. The body fits onto the inside of the cupboard or cabinet, then the plate within a catch attaches to the door or drawer and locks automatically when the door catch engage. The lock is powered by Bluetooth and is operated directly from your smartphone when in range using the Yale app. Power is provided by a single lithium CR2 battery, and Yale says it'll last up to 1 year. Now, the Yale app allows you to unlock and lock the cabinet. It also gives you an audit record of when the cabinet has been opened. Now, to use this remotely, you do need the Yale Wi-Fi bridge to access things remotely and make this all happen. You also can use the Yale keypad to open the lock via a key code. And now, in terms of safety, if you happen to attach this to a cupboard that's big enough for a child to crawl into, then when closed, the Yale cabinet lock lights up when it's dark to highlight the emergency release button if someone happens to get stuck inside. Now, in terms of HomeKit, it supports it without an additional hub. This means a smart lock will connect to HomeKit via Bluetooth and work with the Home app on your iOS device, which allow you to unlock and lock the cabinet. But again, to get remote access, you will need a HomeKit hub such as an Apple TV or HomePod. But again, this is not any different to any other HomeKit accessory when you want remote access. Now, the Yale cabinet lock will retail for €79 in the EU, and this includes the smart cabinet lock, single lithium CR2 battery, and everything you need to get it installed. Although Yale did show off the device in a demo today, they only could say it will be available towards the end of 2020. So it's great to see this kind of device come into HomeKit, and it's certainly going to be something that I'm going to be really interested to get hold of, and hopefully I will be getting a review unit in the next couple of months to do a full hands-on review of this device. So guys, that's the wrap of the HomeKit show. Hopefully you find it interesting this week, and hopefully you've got something out of it and learned something new. If you have, don't forget to give me a thumbs up, and also don't forget to subscribe to the channel and check the rest of the channel out. It might be something that interests you if you're new around here. Also, don't forget to check out our website, homekitauthority.com, and also have a look at our social channels at Follow HomeKit on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. Thank you very much. I'll speak to you soon.